like advantage of moving is coming across all the memory keepsake items that you've saved. And when I was moving, I came across bags and bags of things that I'd saved just in the name of memory. So I thought I should share them all with you. Okay, let's begin with the school uniform. So the first thing I have is my PE uniform, which is my physical education uniform. And I was in the yellow house. It's completely gone, like it has lint all over it. But it looks kind of fashionable, you know. It said Bombay, Cambridge, Gurukul at the back. This was the institution which had like 5 schools under it. So I was in one of those schools. The pants are actually not bad. Like I could still wear them because they are simple track pants like joggers with a side lining. Like ye genuinely abhi trend mein hai, having like one color ka piping on the side. This is what my PE uniform fits me like. It's not as big as I thought it would be, but it is pretty fashionable. It's very comfortable. Then I have my normal school uniform. It was a pinafore, and this was the size of the shirt that I used to wear. How yellow is the collar? It's insane. For a second, I thought it could be makeup, but then I realized school me, I used to never ever wear makeup. So this is next level hilarious because when I was wearing this, I was taking mom's help to do it quickly, and when she was like helping me put up, we both were going back on a nostalgia ride because she literally screamed ki bas sujhaega jaldi kar. It's amazing. I got offended because it is not as loose as I thought it would be. But that's because even in school, when it all right karaya tha, the note would be comfortable just to like fit in. The shirt is huge, like it could literally become a balloon right now. I had like 2 ponies. Actually, my school mein ponies allowed nahi tha lambe baal walon ko. But just to make it more school relatable, I put on 2 ponies. But yeah, this is what I look like in school. Then I have my lab coat, like science practical lectures ke waqt, we used to wear this. This is relatively pretty neat because we had very very few science practical lectures. And then the only other clothing item I have is my t-shirt from my college hobby center. It was like a club, and at the back we had our names. This one is actually very very recent, not from 2007. The person who clicked it at the beach had set the wrong date in their camera. This is my friend Heli. We met at NM College in 11th grade. We just randomly decided to meet at Juhu Beach one fine day, and that's when we took pictures. I really appreciate people over there who are still clicking pictures and giving you prints on the spot because they make for really good memories. Then I have one from BBC, which is the British Brewing Company. I've been there only once, but at that time we did take a picture. This is my school best friend Aishwarya. We've been together since 5th standard, which is over 10 years now. Then I have this printout of me. This is genuinely from 2006, the date, and this is not wrong. 28th of September 2006, I was training for my Trinity course of London for speech and drama, and I had dressed up as Snow White or Cinderella, one of the two, for my act. And this was the whole outfit that we went for. I think this is pretty good. As random as it can get, I have saved all my ID cards in a Ferrero Rocher box. This can't get more Indian. Ferrero Rocher ka box use nahi kiya to matlab paapi kar diya apne idhar. Then I've also saved my whole badge from being in the student council. This was the patch that we had. And then there are 3 buttons over here, so then you would stick it up here. I have kept it so very safely as if this was the most prized possession. You know what? I also have my playgroup ka ID. I have this picture of mom and dad from when they were just engaged. Can it get any more vintage from this? So this is my mom and dad then, and this is what they look like now. It's very cool. I have their wedding invitation cards with me too. We saved quite a few copies. It opened like this. It's so simple, like I love that time. This one was from a vacation to Ganpatipure. We go there every year. Oh, I have my artwork. This one is from 8th standard. Oh, this is good. This is an aster flower. We used to learn this for elementary ka exam, or drawing ka exam rehta, and elementary then intermediate. Then this one is from 6th standard. This was called lettering if I'm not wrong. Then this was 3D sculpture drawing. This was a toothbrush wala painting. This was string art. You dip a string in a pot of paint, then keep it here, and then shut the book and pull the string. So that's how you would get this kind of an effect. This was, I think, an attempt of straw painting. This was a collage which took me ages to complete because I remember mom and I were staying up late at night to finish this, and we only had to use magazines to collect this. And I, like an obedient kid, did not use marble paper. But this was good. I got 9.5 marks out of 10 for this. Next, I have another 8th standard book. I think this is what I was waiting for. We always had to make like a cover picture. So this time I chose to write my treasure. I love the shading in the background though. I think it's pretty cool. Ooh, the finishing on this is great. This is like another freehand drawing. But it has gradients and everything. This is a random monochrome flower. Another 3D cube. I need to pick my paintbrush back up looking at all these things. This is a sunflower, same for the intermediate elementary exam. So we had two flowers in our syllabus, sunflower and aster. And in the final exam, I actually got aster, which I was pretty bummed about. I like the sunflower more. Memory drawing, not gonna talk about it. Oh, this is interesting. This is like a symmetrical freehand, but with a scenery in it. This is called still drawing, still painting. You would have as a setup right in front of you and you had to replicate it. So shadows replicate karna hota tha and the shape should be right, the color should be right. But I was still learning. I don't think that was my strength point. I liked all these random things only, which were easier to do. Oh, this was a scenery drawing. I used the back of a toothpick or a paintbrush to create all these dots. Experimental. We had some 3D art also to do. So for snow and clouds, I stuck cotton. For fencing, popsicles. And for the Christmas tree, fake grass that I had at home at that time. We made a snowman also. And matchsticks for the roof of the hut. This is also nice. This is a fish. And then, you know, to get like this glossy 3D effect, we would put Fevicol all over it and wait for it to dry so it would create a good texture on it. I have all the birthday things that people have made with so much love. This was made by my class's friends and what they did was they put little envelopes all over and each one of them put in letters in it. I think we still have the birthday card from my first birthday, which is this. They made like a Mowgli background and they cut out my photo to imply that I'm also sitting in the whole Mowgli background. And then inside it's just a little message. Now the last thing I want to show you before we end this video, my baby book. Like, you know, when a baby is born, you have this logbook where you write every first thing that happened. So according to this book, I was named Haley because of heavy downpour of rain continuously for 4 to 5 days when I was born. And in my language, Haley means the happiness you feel when the first rains come here. Then my arrival time was 2:09 in the afternoon on 26th of June. It was a Friday. That's nice. And my hair color was light brown. Eye color was light brown. I weighed 3.5 kgs when I was born. I didn't know all of this. Like, I'm legit finding out this with you because every time I read this, it was when I didn't really care about all this information, but now I do. And my length was 19 inches. Family resemblances, most like dad, slightly like mom. And this is written because my dad has filled this, so he had his own bias. The homecoming. My first day in the home was 2nd of July 98 and the memorable events was that there was no light in the house. Everything in the house was messed up due to no light and heavy rains. And the world as it was when I was born. So at that time, popular entertainers were Johnny Lever and Shekhar Suman. Popular songs were Aati Kya Khandala and Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. Yeah, but these were all the memory items that I have saved. And if you enjoyed going down the memory lane with me, then that makes me very, very happy. And I'll see you in the next video. Until then, goodbye!